Hey guys, welcome to another commentary done by Diggity. This is going to be from Starcon, New York City land once again. Never sure whether to say New York City or NYC or NY City. People know what I'm talking about. Upper left hand corner, we got Arcadeplus starting as the yellow turn. Bottom right hand corner, we have Launch starting as the red Zerg. This is on Neo Dark Origin, which is an ASL map this season. And if you guys are not familiar with it, natural expansion, sizable choke. You got this kind of third, so oops, that is not what I wanted to do. Let's get the vision back up. What did I do right there? Hit one of these buttons and it did the thing, and I wasn't expecting it. Anyway, mental note. Anyway, it's got this kind of artifact from, like, say, Ascension, where you can attack from the high ground, and this artifact from, there was a BSL map that I'm forgetting that had this ramp feature as well, but I feel like this ramp feature actually can favor mech, or medic marine. It's pretty strong for Terran. Pretty solid for Zerg as well, because you can plant lurkers on the other side of this, but it's just, you gotta have a pretty wide spread of lurkers where you can see just a pile of medic marines at any of these positions, and it's gonna be very challenging to make your way through. On top of that, there's not a lot of resources on this map. It's a pretty sizable size as far as rush distances main to main, but at the same time, you got the nearby third, but past that, this is maybe your fourth, and that's a pretty big distance and fairly close to your opponent. If you're talking about taking bases top right, that's closer to your opponent than your base. And that's it as far as resources. So you're not really going to get past... the expectation, I would assume, isn't to get past four bases. So it makes very aggressive, interesting games rather than sort of macro-oriented games. Arcadeplus going to go ahead and move out with a scout. He's already got that barracks constructing. It looks like we did see a hatchery first opener on the opposite side from Launch. Try to keep an eye on his gas timing. Going for a pool, actually, before gas. So getting the gas about 208, a little half second later. It's not that huge a deal, but it does slow down the... It can be close with Mutalisk, and it slowed down this Mutalisk a smidge. SCV made its way into the main. Gonna try to... You trying to stay out of vision here? Not quite able to. Drone walking up, seeing that command center. And it looks like it was straight command center, no marine whatsoever. So drone wandering in, is he going to check gas? That's kind of the next thing you want to make sure. That it's, whether it's up, and also count the supply depots. But no gas this time, first marine. Still no marine. Interesting. Upon seeing this, if I was Launch, I might be like, granted it's a distance, it's quite a distance to traverse, but I would be tempted to build a Zergling or two once that spawning pool finishes. Instead, going to go straight to lair before those Zerglings are constructed. He's got a couple Zerglings now building. The Overlord going to try to take position across that edge, SCV making its way back in. Thus far, Launch wanting to, or favoring, I should say, that three hatch style. We'll see if that continues to be the case. I think it's a little bit safer these days. Second barracks in construction, gas tacking on. I assume we're going to see more two racks Academy out of Arcadeplus. SCV taking a good amount of damage. Should be able to make it out as long as he doesn't clip on any artifacts, because well ahead of the Zerglings now. And a bunker defensively being built on the front. It's such a rush distance, you can go ahead and build the bunker and have marines, but this is still pretty wide. Zergling speed is upgrading, and this is a pretty wide area. The Zerglings could sneak across this back range. See if they group up to do so. Speed potentially going to be revealed in just a moment. We do have a tech to lair as well. Spire dropping. So the Zerglings holding. I'm wondering if they're going to make a dive, though, because this is a big open area, and we don't have a lot of supply depot clutter or anything else here at the natural. So once speed finishes, could swing all the way around. SCV actually able to walk right by these Zerglings. Lazy little jerks. A drone also moving out. He wants to go ahead and plop down an additional base. It looks like he's going to go to the bottom left-hand corner, though, rather than that nearby 3 o'clock location. I'm not sure if that's unfamiliarity with the map or strategically trying to dodge where you would expect typical bases. SCV now been scouted by the Zerglings. They're trying to get a surround blockade. Is the drone going to hold the ramp to deny information? Almost, yes. Well, SCV's still able to get in, so it's going to be able to see that spire timing. And now we're gonna need some turrets. Gonna need some turrets back along that corner. SV's seeing that spire. Engineering bay. And Stimpak being upgraded. No Comsat station needed. And we've had arcades with that SCV sitting near that Vespin geyser, though he's going to take it, but it's been holding off on it. So now checking the main a little bit, maybe to see what sort of turret placement potentially could be there. Bottom left-hand base being grabbed. Mutalisks starting to be constructed. A turret right now at the natural expansion. And a turret near the barracks line. It looks like a third barracks being tacked on. So arcade once again favoring the three barracks opener. Gonna have to play a little bit more defensively. Let's see if he hits that plus one weapons this time. The delay on that, I think, set him back a little bit. Missile turret hanging out. He's only got one turret, however, in that natural expansion. And we've got a good amount of mutalisks and plus one being upgraded. And right now, okay, now a second turret being added on. If Launch had really gotten a move on, he might have been able to create some harassment over there. And that's still, honestly, a pretty harassable natural expansion with the turret positioning. One beautiful thing about this map, though, is as you can see the Mutalist looking to engage the Medic Marine on the bridge and create, because that's a very abusive scenario where they have trouble positioning, can get strung out. Engaging with just four Mutalists right there, checking in. And one stranded, couple stranded. It looks like they might just be free fire. Finally regrouping and getting some shots on the Marines that are staggering. Able to at least get three kills. One of them heavily damaged, however. The Zerglings just waiting nearby. Three turrets now at the natural, but again, I feel like this angle, if you can get the with some decent micro, could hang out on the extent. But critically here for Arcadeplus, able to get over that bridge. Extractor being dropped bottom left-hand corner to get that third gas up online. Range just about to be finished. Ooh, one Marine stranding himself to the far corner. Do we have a factory back here yet as well? I'm not seeing. So it looks like we have four barracks, but no factory as of yet. So the mass of Mutalisks actually might end up paying off for Launch. Plus one weapons, not that far from finishing. Arcadeplus being very aggressive with his forward positioning. And actually not going to be punished for it either, because there's no Sunken Colonies here on the front. Might be enough, yeah, spotting it now, but with this control group of Mutalists, that might be sufficient. Overlord taking some damage. Zerglings now pressing up. Overlord down, that at least is not putting Arcadeplus in the red, but this is at his rally point. And a lot of, oof, the Mutalists eating a lot of fire. So Arcadeplus, with the aggression, getting some success with it, re-engaging, and now attacking the Mutalisks wholesale. And usually Mutalisks want some room to micro back and forth. Another grouping of Medic Marines walking their way in. The natural expansion now breached, where the Marines are engaging, peppering the drones. No drones have been taken out just as of yet, but the Mutalisks have been taking heavy fire, and yeah, right on top of the spawn point as well. In Arcadeplus, with a very aggressive maneuver, able to punish Launch because he didn't have Sunken Colonies prepared for this, was relying on the Mutalist numbers, and as a result, Arcadeplus takes the win, 2-0. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you want to see the main grouping of casts, go ahead and go to Artosis Casts channel. Check it out, give him support. If you don't watch him, you're not a Brood War fan, is basically what it comes down to. You're just a poser. Brood War poser, something, insults, unless you're following Artosis is what I'm saying. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed it regardless. Thanks for listening.